For the given figure, if line AD intersects BE at point C and x is equals to 100 degrees, to figure out the value of y, we can start by calculating the third internal angle of triangle ABC by subtracting the other two from 180. Now, since the line segment AD and BE are intersecting, so they will make the same 60 degree angle on the corresponding side. Finally, y can be calculated by subtracting the two other internal angles from 180. If the two sides of the triangle are extended as shown in the figure, to calculate the value of x, we can start by figuring out the third internal angle of the triangle by subtracting the other two from 180. Next, since x and theta forms a straight line, their sum will be equals to 180. Simplifying it will give us the value of x. For the given figure, if line M and N are parallel and we have to calculate the value of B, we can start by noting that angle 130 degree and A are supplementary, so their sum will be equals to 180. Next, since line L is perpendicular to line M, that means that it is making a 90 degree angle. Finally, we can calculate the angle B by subtracting the other two internal angles from 180. If the three lines intersect at point P and x equals to 65 while y equals to 75, to calculate the angle Z, we can start by noting that the angle between x and Z will be equals to y, as it is opposite to the intersecting lines. Next, since x, y, and z makes a straight line, so their sum will be 180. Simplifying will give us the value of z. If line L and K are parallel, to calculate angle A, we know that line J is intersecting the two parallel lines, so it will make the same angle with both of them. Next, since angle A and 64 degree makes a straight line, so their sum is equals to 180. Simplifying will give us the value of A. For the given figure, if line AC is extended to point D and the angle BAC is equals to angle BCA, in order to find the value of x, we can start by first calculating the angle BAC by subtracting 110 from 180. Next, since the sum of internal angles of the triangle is equals to 180, we can simplify and get the value of x. For the given figure, if line C intersects parallel lines S and T, in order to figure out the angle X, we can start by noting that line C will make the same angle with the intersecting parallel lines. Next, the angle X and 110 makes a straight line, so their sum will be 180. Simplifying will give us the value of X. For the given triangle, if A is equals to 45 degree, to find the value of B, we can start by noting that the sum of internal angles of a triangle is 180. Simplifying gives us the value of third angle as 104. Dividing by 2 will give us the value of B. If line M and N are parallel to each other, then the intersecting line L will make the same 26 degree angle with both of them. Next, X can be calculated by subtracting 26 from 180, as both the X and 26 are supplementary angles as they make a straight line. If the Washington Monument cast a shadow of 300 feet, while a nearby cherry tree cast a shadow of 16 feet, and if the monument is approximately 555 feet long, to figure out the height of cherry tree, we can use the principle of similar triangles. By taking the ratio of the sides of the triangle, we can get the height of the tree, that is coming 30 feet. For the given figure, if line L and M are parallel, and y equals to 20 degrees, while z equals to 60 degrees. In order to figure out the angle x, we know that an intersecting line will make the same angle with the parallel lines. So x can be calculated by subtracting 20 and 60 from 180. For the given figure, if line segment WZ and XY intercept at point Q, and the line segment YQ is equals to 63, while WQ is 70, WX is 60, and finally XQ is 120. To figure out the length YZ, we can start by noting that the intersecting lines will have the same opposite angles. Since the two angles are same for the triangle, the third will also be identical. Now, by taking the ratio of the sides of similar triangles, we can solve for the side YZ, which is coming 54.